Hey everyone, Gerbil here. Welcome back. Today's video, I want to talk about Nissa and a buff, and I mean a big buff that she got that almost, I don't think anyone has observed yet. It came without notice from CG. This is September 9th, and notice what's happening versus September 15th. One more time. Can you catch it? This buff is actually going to be really big. If you're not getting it, that's okay. Let me give you a hint here. Spin, throw. Yes, the animation for her basic was sped up. And this is huge because Nissa can attack 6 times with a single assist. Not joking. If Nissa is called to assist by another ally, she's also attacking out of turn when they use the special ability, which means that she will attack with her basic using assist, but then her special kicks in and she assists on top of that. And if each of those are critical hits, she will attack 6 times, which enables her to hit for an insane amount of damage on an assist. Now, we just saw Revan falling down from 3 hits, but watch this. 1, 2, 3, 4 assists for 73,000 damage. And we're gonna see another one here against Basilisk Shan. Relic 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and that's a kill. If that had not been a kill, she likely would have assisted a 6th time, and she had already done 104,000 damage. 1, 2, 3. Now that was just an out of turn attack, but that still hit Master Yoda for 45,000 damage. It's insane. So yes, I have Relic 9'd 3 of my Ewoks with the intent of taking the full squad to Relic 9. Why? Because they're my favorite faction and not to make them good. Nissa has already elevated them to an insane level that just people are not understanding. I've seen a lot of very, very, very good content creators who honestly know a lot more about the game than me still saying that Nissa is not very good. And why is that? That's because her animation used to be so slow, she would time out even on offense. Like, you would go up against a viable opponent and they would time out because her animation, if she assisted 6 times, could take a full 9 to 10 seconds per assist. Not anymore. She is now assisting up to 6 times in as little as 3.5 seconds. So as a result of this acceleration of her basic, you're no longer timing out when you're going up against even teams like Jedi Master Luke that are really, really hard to get through. Spoiler alert, if Gas is there, you're not gonna get through probably. Gas prevents revives and it's got all that cooldown manipulation, so it kind of just sucks. But teams like Starkiller, Revan, and almost any other non-GL team, I am successfully getting through pretty easily. Omicron Phasma in Territory Wars is no problem. Omicron Geonosians is a challenge, but now with the accelerated animation, I think that it will actually be quite easy to get through. Honestly, the clock was the biggest problem. So this acceleration of the animation enables you to take the turns necessary to punch your way through. And of course, just the number of times Nissa's attacking, and every time an Ewok attacks out of turn, they're applying damage over time to the target through Nissa's kit. So if Nissa attacks by herself, for example, 6 times out of turn, that's 6 damage over time effects you can land on a target. So if you're spreading those damage over times around on your opponents, you don't even have to kill them. You just apply a bunch of damage over times, do a bunch of paper cuts with your team attacking, and then you will inevitably kill the enemy team as they take their own turns and die to the dots. It's wacky wild. So this is a pretty solid Jedi Master Luke team here, just as an example. It is Relic 7. Oh, and I just noticed he doesn't have his ultimate. Oh no, he is in his ultimate. He's already used his ultimate. Ah, that's cool. So yeah, like I said, if Gas is there, you're not going to get through it, but it's just to showcase the viability of these things. If they are beating, and this is an arena, no Omicrons, and I'm using matching or no Datacrons. As you'll see, there's no Datacron on the team right now presently applied. So in these situations, I am handedly defeating full Relic 8 plus CLS teams, Revan, Darth Revan, with a caveat, if the Darth Revan squad has both Sith Empire Trooper and Malak. I don't know if you're going to get through it. The pre-taunt on Sith Empire Trooper makes a big difference. But without him, and I'll explain the strategy in a second, specifically against Darth Revan, it's honestly not that challenging. Malak is not a problem. You wouldn't think, right? You'd think that Malak would just eat them, but no, Malak himself is not a problem. The problem is just getting out ahead of Darth Revan and Bassla Shan, which in Territory Wars, Nissa will start with 100% turn meter. So if you're running your bears in Territory Wars, then they're gonna roll over a lot of squads if you are in control. On defense, I'm not so sure. So here's how it works. Don't anger Malak, okay? Start off, don't anger Malak. In other words, don't attack him. Don't use any AoEs. Focus down on Bassla Shan. Make sure you get Chirpa to 100% turn meter so you can do that right there. Call everybody to assist, spreading more turn meter, getting more assist from Nissa, and you eliminate her, which takes away, I'd say, 50% of the concern or the worry. Now, yes, this is not a full Sith Empire trooper. I mean, come on, our Sith Empire team, but there's always a caveat, right? And again, we're in arena, this which is not where Ewoks are going to shine the most. The Chirpa GAC Omicron is going to guarantee another assist every turn. So Nissa's going to assist every turn, and then another a random Ewok, which again could be Nissa again, will assist every special, which means you're going to be pumping out a lot more turn meter, applying a lot more dots, and you also get 40% more offense, which is going to make Nissa even more powerful. In GAs, or in Territory Wars, again, she'll start with 100% turn meter and all kinds of other shenanigans that make them way beefier. So why Ewok then? Why care? Well, with GL Leia being now the new cream de la cream, right? Many people are going to have a Relic 7 Nissa, a Relic 3 Wicket and Chirpa. Relic up Lawgrave for Rise of the Empire, and you only need one more Ewok, and you've got this squad right here. It's something to consider, folks. Anyway, thank you for watching. I hope you've enjoyed. I'll see you around. Oh, give me a like and subscribe, please. Okay, bye-bye.